Welcome to Stigmatized Drummer Tutorial Series. I am Dimitris Dalamitras from Stigmatized Productions. In this tutorial, we will focus in the third section of Stigmatized Drummer, the kit page. In the kit page, we have a visual representation of our drum kit. We see all the elements, and we can control from this page volume, tune, attack, hold, and decay. That's very easy, and we can do it two ways. First way is to select every different kit piece by pressing or pressing MIDI select and pressing our MIDI keyboard. It's exactly the same. These controls are corresponding to the selected drum element. For example, if I press snare, these controls are now for snare. Let's say I raise the volume of snare. Now the volume is 9 dB more, but it's only for snare. If I press something else, it comes to default. Pressing snare again, we have its value. Pressing Command and left click, or for Windows, Control and left click, it comes again to the default, to zero. We can select everything from here and adjust its volume. And I have to say that the volume corresponding to the direct microphone. Not the others. The other microphones from overheads, from room, etc., are controlled from this matrix router, and it will be covered in a next tutorial. The direct volume, as I said, is controlled by pressing each kit piece and the slider. With the tune slider, we can control all the boosts. For example, pressing snare and make it lower, it happens to everything. Or higher. We can go to extreme values. And again, pressing Command and left click for Macintosh or Control and left click for Windows, it comes to the default situation. We can control attack. Now I make it softer with less attack. Full attack again. Adjusting hall and decay, we can make it sound roomier or less roomier. We can control its hold or decay, make it shorter, or even too short if we want. And we can play with the values until we find our best spot for every element. A fast example to show how we can make our drum set more soft if we want, or less roomy if we want, with these sliders. I suppose volume and tune sliders are very self-explanatory and it's very easy to understand. For example, let's say have the snare. I like to have crack, too much crack in snare. But if I want less crack, one way is to use to go to snare, to the mixer. In next tutorial, I will show, and to go to the equalizer and cut some highs. Okay. But if I don't want to come in equalizer situations, I can simply make it less attack. And it will be more soft, not so cracky. Listen. Till you find the right spot. When you find it, and when you like this spot, you stay like this. Another situation. For to make easy to understand, I will make too much the room sound. Here is my room sound. I will make it enough for to show something. Now I don't care for cracking. I want the room because when you have the room sound and in many situations, producers tend to squash, to compress it too much for to have real room sound and too much room sound in their drum kit, on their drum kit. But let's say you don't want so much reverberation of the room, but you want the bigness of the room. You can make something like this. Here I have too much room. You can decrease hold till you find the right spot and decay. And you will see it's getting smaller. Not the room, the reverberation. You see? So you have the roomy sound and not so much the reverberation. The same happens to kick, toms and everything. I will make a fast example playing a groove from extreme metal situations and to listen with the much roomy sound, and later I will try to compensate it. Listen. Too much room, I like it, okay, but let's say I want to compensate a little bit. And I don't want to go to room and to... You can go and slow it. But now, this time, I have smaller drums. I want this bigness. I want this bigness, but not so much reverberation. Okay, first thing. Let's select first snare. Now everything I will make here, it will come to the snare. I will try to manipulate it till it's... Now it's not so much reverberation. The same with kicks. I can go further if I want. I can go almost much more further. Now it's too much. I want a little bit more. I want a little bit more. Okay. In this situation, as you saw, we were able, using only these sliders, hold and decay, to make the room obvious, but with not so much reverberation in it. Of course, it depends to everyone's taste. Another producer would like all the room, like this. If it's too much, coming to here to the room. Anyway, using the volume and tune sliders, with the helping of attack, hold and decay, you can make your drum kit sound as exactly you want. I forgot to note that all these sliders, in the kit section, or groove section, or mixer section, matrix section, faders, panners, and generally most of the controls are fully automatable. It means we can press right click in a control, select Learn MIDI CC automation, and if we have connected our external MIDI controller, we can control from there. Thanks for watching. See you in next video. Stay tuned.